Now Jose, the Colombian necktie Cortes in the blue trunks, is going to be stepping into the cage and fighting, I think, a really competitive fight here at 155. And as far as Cortes is concerned, he's fighting out of Cali, Colombia, and he's got so many fans here tonight. He really wants to win this badly. Let's throw it up to Christopher James. You heard that Colombian crowd, Hawk. I told you.
I mean, we may be the United States, but there's no doubt he has the home field advantage here with the hometown crowd. I'd say about one-tenth of all of Colombia is here to witness him.
Alrighty, this fight scheduled for 3 5-minute rounds in the lightweight division. Preston Parsons in the black trunks with yellow trim, and Jose Cortes in the blue fighter energy trunks. Scheduled for 3 5-minute rounds. Referee James Waring making sure that the cage is locked down. Here we go.
Now, I admit, I have to, Parsons going right for the cage. Now, those who are at home, remember the first House of Fame, Parsons was on that card, A New Dawn, back in September 2014. He won with a very sick armbar submission. Let me tell you, and I realize I'm being a little biased here, that I've worked with him, I've trained with this guy. He is a prodigy, only 19 years old. I mean, if you were to look at all his accolades, he has more accolades than most 40-year-olds do who have been competing for 20 years. This kid has a very, very, very bright future ahead of him.
Yeah, you could see it, Hawk. At the very beginning of the fight, he stuck the left hand out, the jab, as a distraction. Immediately went to his wrestling. He's got sick wrestling. He got Jose down quite easily. Now moving over into side control, letting the elbows go.
You know, a lot of fighters, you could say, you could kind of compare them maybe to, like, quarterbacks in the NFL. You know, I mean, you can train them, you can teach them, you can show them all the X's and O's, but they're obviously that very special brand that they see the fight. They are just like a quarterback will see the field, he'll see his wide receivers. You know, some fighters truly just see the fight. You almost don't have to coach them. Preston is one of those special prodigies.
And Hawk, already a big mouse developing under the left eye of Jose. And that was that big right nasty elbow that Parsons was. Oh, there it goes again.
Down the elbows.
I'll tell you, oh, he's dominant from this position. He's got half mount here. And Jose trying to compose the guard. He needs to compose the guard. He needs to pull Parsons down. He cannot be posturing up like this. He is damaging Jose.
Parsons, obviously, they've kind of moved to a half guard position. You know, obviously, he's trying to get that mount. Uh-oh, he almost has that full mount.
Looking for that arm and head choke. Maintaining top position. Good job by Jose to get back to his feet. Great work there by Jose, but he took some damage.
Slip on Parsons. Doesn't look like he took too much damage. That was more of a slip than the knockdown, but still. He's a little bit lucky that Jose wasn't able to take advantage of that.
Well, you know, again, the wrestling, Hawk. He was able to shoot the single from that position. Not too many people think of that, you know, to shoot the single, to turn a horrible situation into offense like that.
Again, like I said earlier, he sees the field, he sees the cage. He's a special, you know, definitely a special fighter that sees the fight. You almost don't even need to coach him.
Getting down low now, shooting the single. He's gonna try to lift. He wants to get some air.
Now he wants to make sure that he doesn't exhaust himself, you know, trying to go, you know, for this dump here. obviously, you know, you can see that both fighters are starting to wear down already a little bit with all the amount of damage they've taken already in these 3.5 minutes.
It was an amazing expenditure of energy by both of these lightweights. And, you know, it shows you have to be in elite condition to compete in this sport. You're going against a guy who's trying to take your head off. He's trying to make you go to sleep. You cannot let your guard down at all for that 5 minutes.
You know, when you think about it, sitting in traffic, whatnot, 5 minutes or perhaps 15 minutes doesn't seem like that long. Let me tell you, from somebody who's been in the cage many, many times, it feels like a lifetime when another human being is trying to take your head off.
Oh, right now, Jose going for the choke. Now he's trying to double it up.
He needs to lift his head and make sure that Jose does not take him to the ground. He needs to do everything he can to elevate himself.
He almost suplexed him. What's the defense right here for Parsons on this choke?
Well, he needs to make sure he gets his legs up in the air, try to get some leverage.
All right, Jose gave up on it, Hawk. So now it's more ground and pound for Parsons. Go ahead.
Well, I was going to say, it seems that Parsons is, even though he is trying to advance his position, pretty much both fighters are, I call this a little bit of a recovery period for them. You can see they're just a bit gassed.
Oh, full mount, left hand, right.
This could be
left,
the fight.
Left. Oh, and now he softens him up. Going for the choke. He may have time. Looking to tighten it up.
If you're Cortes, you've got to get those legs back.
He's done. He finished him. Preston Parsons with the rear naked choke. What a beautiful win for Preston's, the prodigy, Parsons.
I think I just gave him his
nickname. You gave him the nickname. And I hope BJ Penn will relinquish it without any pushback.
You know, we may have to have BJ come out of retirement to fight for the nickname. Winner keeps the nickname.
Wow, you weren't kidding about Preston Parsons. It's really the wrestling.
Pretty much the only 155-pounder that I know that's actually able to give me trouble. And I probably have 50, 60 pounds on him anytime when we wrestle. And he still gives me trouble.
Wow.
That should give you an idea of his skill set. But you didn't hear that from me. The rest of the world, you didn't hear that from me.
Quick break. When we come back, we'll talk to the winner, Preston Parsons. Don't forget, we still have Hyander Rodriguez facing Gleitson De Jesus. Rashawn Spencer will square off against Patrick Dixon. And in our main event, Danny Chavez will step into the cage to face Anderson Hutchinson. Stay with us.
Ladies and gentlemen, referee James Ware stops this bout at 4 minutes and 26 seconds of the very first round. For your winner by submission, due to a rear naked choke, Preston Parsons.
All right, I'm here with the winner, Preston Parsons. And Preston really showed why wrestling is such a foundational element to the sport of MMA. You were able to implement the single and the double leg takedown when you needed to. Even when he had you in trouble, you were able to turn it into offense by shooting the single. And that's really what made the difference. It put you in the dominant position throughout the fight.
Yes, sir. I want to thank God. I want to thank Jose. Thank you for fighting me, man. I want to thank all my friends, my family that made it out here tonight. Most of all, I want to thank all my sponsors, Fighter Energy, Prep Works. I want to thank Quadrant, Information Security. I want to thank NutriShop Jacksonville back at home, keeping me up on my supplements. I want to thank Doctors Express for keeping me healthy. Most of all, I want to thank every one of my coaches, my Muay Thai coach, my training partners, my wrestling coach, and the man behind my success, my head coach. Thank you guys so much. I love you guys. And thank you guys again. I'll see you guys soon.
At just 19 years old, a bright future for Preston Parsons, everybody.
outside.